discuss critical path method. Critical path method is denoted by CPM. Once the network is in our hand, we determine the time of completion of the project. This time is not the sum of the duration of individual activities because some of the activities can be processed simultaneously. Thus, the total time of completion of a project depends on certain activities known as critical activities. The path connecting these activities is known as critical path, and the sum of duration of activities along a critical path determines the completion time of the project. Now we will discuss that how to find critical path. Before going into discussion of critical path determination, let's first define some notations. Some notations are as given. Tij. Tij represents the time duration of activity emanating from node I and ending at node j. And then capital E, capital Si, it is represented by rectangle. What is this? This is earliest starting time of activities emanating from node I. Mathematically, it is calculated as maximum over k of earliest start time of kth node plus time duration of activity emanating from node k and ending at node I. This I can explain in the example. Next is capital L, capital C, I. It is represented by a triangle. What is this? This is latest completion time of activities coming to node I. Mathematically, it can be calculated as minimum over the node j, minimum of latest completion time of jth node minus time duration of activity emanating from node I and ending node j and ending at node j. Also, by convention, we fixed earlier start time of first node is equal to latest completion time of first node equal to 0. That is, earlier start time of first node and latest completion time of first node is 0. And latest completion time of last node is equal to earlier start time of last node. Here, small l stands for the last node. The next definition is of critical activity. An activity ij emanating from node I and terminating at node j like this, it is emanating from I and terminating at node j, is called critical activity if and only if three conditions are satisfied. First is earliest start time of ith node is equal to latest completion time of ith node. Second is earliest start time of jth node is equal to latest completion time of jth node. Third is the difference of earliest start time of jth node and earliest start time of ith node is equal to difference of latest completion time of jth node and latest completion time of ith node further equals to time duration of activity I and j. Like this, this is Tij represents the time duration of activity I and j. Latest completion time of ith node is equal to earliest start time of ith node. That is, these both are equal. And then latest completion time of jth node and earliest start time of jth node, these both are equal. And further, the difference of these two is equal to the time duration. If these three conditions are satisfied, then we set activity I and j as critical activity. Now I am going to discuss how to find critical path with the help of following example. Find the critical path of the following network using critical path method or CPM. Here, this is the network given as, and the time duration of various activities are given like this. Here, 2 represents the time duration of activity 1, 2, 3, and other time durations are represented in similar manner. Now I am going to discuss how to find critical path. To find critical path, first we have to find earliest start time and latest completion time of all the nodes. Earliest start time, the formula for earliest start time is given as maximum over the node k of earliest start time of kth node plus time duration of activity kl. And similarly, the formula for latest completion time is given by this. Now we will discuss how we find earliest start time with the help of this formula. Now, by convention, earliest start time of first node is 0. Therefore, we take here earliest start time of first node 0. Now, we have to find earliest start time of second node, that is ES2. Now, first you have to look that activities that are end at node 2. Here, one activity is end at node 2. Therefore, earliest start time of 2 is equal to earliest start time of first node plus time duration of this node. That is maximum of earliest start time of first node ES1 plus time duration of this activity, that is 3. We have earliest start time of first node as 0. This means 0 plus 3, 3. And maximum of 3 is 3. Therefore, earliest start time of second node is 3. Now we will find earliest start time of third node. First we look that how many activities are end at node 3. Now at node 3, one activity is end from 1 to 3 and second activity is end from 2 to 3. Therefore, earliest start time of 3 is maximum of one activity's end from 1 to 3. That means earliest start time of first node plus time duration of this activity. That is earliest start time of first node plus time duration of this activity, that is 2. Then a activity 2 to 3 is also ends at 3. Therefore, earliest start time of second node, that is ES2, plus time duration of this activity, that is 0. Therefore, it becomes maximum of earliest start time of first node is 0, that is 0 plus 2, and earliest start time of second node is 3, that is 3 plus 0, that is maximum of 2 and 3, that is 3. Therefore, earliest start time of third node is 3. Now we will find earliest start time of fourth node. First we look how many activities are end at node 4. The activities end at node 4 is activity 3 to 4 and activity 2 to 4. Therefore, earliest start time of fourth node is maximum of activity 3 to 4 end at 4. Therefore, earliest start time of node 3 plus time duration of this activity, that is ES3 plus time duration of this activity is 4. Then 2 to 4 is also ends at 4. Therefore, earliest start time of second node plus time duration of this activity, that is 2. Therefore, maximum of earliest start time of third node is 3, that is 3 plus 4. Earliest start time of second node is 3, that is 3 plus 2. That is maximum of 7 and 5, that is 7. Therefore, earliest start time of node 4th is 7. Now we will find earliest start time of fifth node. First we look how many activities are end at node 5. Activity 3 to 5 ends at 5. Activity 4 to 5 ends at 5. Therefore, earliest start time of fifth node is maximum of earliest start as activity 3 to 5 ends at 5, therefore earliest start time of third node plus time duration of this activity, that is 5. Also activity 4 to 5 is ends at node 5, therefore earliest start time of fourth node plus time duration of this activity, that is 6. Earliest start time of third node is 3, that is 3 plus 5. Earliest start time of fourth node is 7, that is 7 plus 6. This is maximum of 8 and 13. Maximum of 8 and 13 is 13. Therefore, it is 13. Then, earliest start time of 6th node is, first we look that how many activities end at node 6. Activity 2 to 6, activity 4 to 6, activity 5 to 6, 3 activities end at node 6. Therefore, earliest start time of node 6 is maximum of 2 to 6 activity end at node 6. Therefore, earliest start time of second node plus time duration of this activity, that is 7. Also, activity 4 to 6 ends at node 6. Therefore, earliest start time of fourth node plus time duration of this activity, that is 11. Also activity 5 to 6 ends at node 6. Therefore, earlier start time of 5th node plus time duration of this activity, that is 3. Therefore, maximum of earlier start time of 2nd node is 3, which we have already calculated. Earliest start time of 4th node is 7, already calculated. Earliest start time of 5th node is 13, already calculated. This becomes maximum of 10, 18 and 16. Maximum 10, 18 and 16 is 18. Therefore, earliest start time of 6th node is 18. In this way, we can find earliest start time of each node. Now we will discuss how we find the latest completion time of all the nodes. Now we will discuss how to find latest completion time of all the nodes. The formula for latest completion time is minimum over the jth node of latest completion time of jth node minus time duration of activity I to j. In case of latest completion time, you have to start from last node, as by convention earliest start time of, by convention we have earlier start time of last node, our last node is 6, earlier start time of last node and latest completion time of last node is equal. Therefore, LC6, latest completion time of 6th node is 18. Here we write 18. Now we will find the latest completion time of 5th node. How to find latest completion time of 5th node? You have to check how many activities out from node 5. From node 5, only one activity is out, that is 5 to 6. To find the latest completion time of node 5, first you have to check how many activities are out from node 5. From node 5, only one activity is out, that is 5 to 6. Therefore, latest completion time of 5th node is minimum of latest completion time of 6th node minus time duration of 5 to 6 activity. Time duration of 5 to 6 activity is 3. That means LC6 minus 3 is equal to minimum of, as latest completion time of 6 node is 18. This becomes 18 minus 3. That is minimum of 15 is 15. Now we will find latest completion time of 4th node. Latest completion time of 4th node. Before calculating latest completion time of 4th node, we look that how many activities out from node 4. Here, from node 4, one activity is out 4 to 5 and other activity is out 4 to 6. That means two activities are out from node 4. One is 4 to 5 and the other is 4 to 6. Therefore, latest completion time of 4th node is minimum of, one activity is out 4 to 6, that is latest completion time of 6th node, minus time duration of activity 4 to 6. Time duration of activity 4 to 6 is 11. And the second activity which is out from node 4 is 4 to 5. Therefore, latest completion time of 5th node minus time duration of activity 4 to 5, that is 6. This becomes minimum of, latest completion time of 6th node is 18, that is 18 minus 11. Latest completion time of 5th node is 15, that is 15 minus 6. This becomes minimum of 18 minus 11, that is 7, 15 minus 6, that is 9, minimum of 7 and 9 is 7. Therefore, latest completion time of 4th node is 7. We have already calculated latest completion time of 5th node is 15. Now we will calculate latest completion time of 3rd node. First we will check how many activities out from node 3. How many activities out from node 3? From node 3, two activities are out. One is from 3 to 5 and the other is from 3 to 4. Now we will calculate latest completion time of 3rd node, that is minimum of, as one activity is out from node 3, that is 3 to 5, therefore latest completion time of 5th node minus time duration of this activity 3 to 5, that is 5. Then another activity is out from node 3, that is 3 to 4, latest completion time of 4th node minus time duration of this activity, that is 4. That is minimum of, latest completion time of 5th node we have already calculated, that is 15 minus 5. Latest completion time of 4th node is 7, that is 7 minus 4. This becomes minimum of 15 minus 5, that is 10, 7 minus 4, that is 3, and minimum of 10 and 3 is 3. Therefore, latest completion time of 3rd node is 3. Now we will calculate latest completion time of 2nd node, LC2. First we will check how many activities out from node 2. Here from node 2, two activities are out. One is 2 to 3 and the other is 2 to 4. One is 2 to 3 and the other is 2 to 4 and the next is 2 to 6. Three activities are out from node 2, that is 2 to 3, 2 to 4, 2 to 6. Now we will calculate latest completion time of 2nd node. First we check how many activities are out from node 2? From node 2, 3 activities are out. One is 2 to 3, another is 2 to 4, and the other is 2 to 6. Therefore, latest completion time of node 2 is minimum of first activity which is out from node 2 is 2 to 3. Therefore, latest completion time of third node minus time duration of this activity, that is 0. And then second activity that is out from node 2 is 2 to 4. Therefore, latest completion time of fourth node minus time duration of this activity, that is 2. And the other activity which is out from node 2 is 2 to 6. Therefore, latest completion time of sixth node minus time duration of this activity, that is 7. This is minimum of latest completion time of third node is, we have already calculated, that is 3. 3 minus 0. Latest completion time of fourth node we have already calculated, 7. That is 7 minus 2. Latest completion time of sixth node we have already calculated, 18. That is 18 minus 7. This becomes minimum of 3, 5, and 11, that is 3. Therefore, latest completion time of third node is 3. Now, either we calculate latest completion time of first node, latest completion time of first node, the latest completion time of first node is how many activities out from node first? From node first, two activities are out. One is 1 to 3 and the other is 1 to 2. One is 1 to 3 and the other is 1 to 2. Therefore, latest completion time of first node is minimum of first activity is 1 to 3. That means latest completion time of 3 minus time duration of this activity, that is 2, and the second activity is 1 to 2. That means latest completion time of activity 2 minus time duration of this activity, that is 3. This becomes minimum of latest completion time of third node is 3. This is 3 minus 2. Latest completion time of second node is 3. This is 3 minus 3. This becomes minimum of 1 and 0, that is 0. Therefore, latest completion time of first node is 0. And also, by convention, we can use latest completion time of first node is also 0. That is, in this way, we can find all the latest completion times of all the nodes and earliest start time of all the nodes. Now, to join the critical path, first we have to identify critical activities. We look one by one activity that whether it is critical activity or not. For activity 1 to 2, here earliest start time of first node and latest completion time of first node is equal. Earliest start time of second node and latest completion time of second node is equal. And the third condition is the difference of these two and these two equal to time duration. Therefore, 3 minus 0, 3 minus 0 equal to 3. Therefore, activity 1 to 2 is critical activity. Now, we look whether 1 to 3 is critical activity or not. For this, these two are equal, these two are equal, and the difference of these two equal to the time duration. Here, 3 minus 0 not equal to 2, therefore activity 1 to 3 is not critical activity. Now we will look for 2 to 3. 2 to 3, 1 to 3 is not critical activities. 1 to 3 is not critical activity. Now we will look for 2 to 3. Here 3 3 equals 3 3 equals, and the difference of these two, 3 minus 3 equal to 0. Therefore this is critical activity. Therefore 2 to 3 is critical activity. Now we will check for 3 to 4. 7 7 equal, 3 3 equal, and the difference of these two, 7 minus 3, 7 minus 3 equal to time duration, that is 4. Therefore 3 to 4 is critical activity. Now we will look for 4 to 5. For 4 to 5, as these two are not equal, because for critical activity, earlier start time of 5th node is equal to latest completion time of 5th node. But these are not equal, therefore activity 4 to 5 is not critical activity. And the same reason holds for activity 3 to 5. Latest completion time of 5th node and earliest start time of 5th node are not equal. Therefore, activity 3 to 5 is also not an critical activity. Now, we will check for activity 4 to 6, whether 4 to 6 is critical activity or not. Here 7 7 equals, 18 18 equals, and 18 minus 7, that is equal to time duration 11. Therefore activity 4 to 6 is critical activity. Now we will check for activity 2 to 6, whether it is critical activity or not. Here activity 2 to 6, 3 3 equals, 18 18 equals, but 18 minus 3, that is 15, not equal to 7. Therefore 2 to 6 activity is not critical activity. Now we will check for 2 to 4. 3 3 equals, 7 7 equals, but 7 minus 3 equal to 4. 4 not equal to 2. Therefore 2 to 4 is also not critical activity. Now we will look for 5 to 6. For 5 to 6, as in case of 5, earliest start time not equal to latest completion time, therefore activity 5 to 6 is also not critical activity. Now the critical activities are 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 6. Now we use double arrow for these critical activities, that is 1 to 2, then 2 to 3, then 3 to 4, then 4 to 6. Now by joining these activities, that is 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 6, we will get the critical path. We will get the critical path 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 6. The double arrows, the activities which are represented by double arrows, that represent critical activities. In this way, we can find the critical path. Now, the time duration of the project is, time duration of project is 1 to 2. 1 to 2 is, time duration is 3. Then 2 to 3. 2 to 3 time duration is 0. Then 3 to 4. 3 to 4 time duration is 4. Then 4 to 6. 4 to 6 time duration is 11. That is 18. Therefore, time duration for project is 18 days. In this way, we can find the critical path, and after finding the critical path, we can find the total time duration of project. One thing is important here, that in calculating earliest start time, you go from first node to last node, and in calculating latest completion time, you comes from last node to first node.
फ्रेंड्स, अगर आपको हमारी ये वीडियो अच्छी लगी तो प्लीज हमारे इस चैनल को सब्सक्राइब कीजिए, और ये जो वीडियो के नीचे बेल आइकॉन का बटन दिया हुआ है, इसे प्रेस कीजिए, जिससे आपको हमारी न्यू वीडियोस की नोटिफिकेशन मिलती रहेगी. थैंक यू फ्रेंड्स, कीप वॉचिंग अवर वीडियोज़.